Well, hello, everybody. We are coming at you with another episode of Talk of the Town podcast. Each week, we bring you valuable insight and information that directly affects our local business community. I'm Danielle Hawley, and I'm proud to say that I'm the executive director of the best Chamber of Commerce around, the Fontana Chamber of Commerce. And I'm proud to bring you our Talk of the Town podcast with my co-host, Mr. Carlos Garcia of FYI Technologies. How's it going, Carlos?
Fantastic, Danielle. Glad to be here.
Love it. Just living the dream. Another week. We are so excited. Well, this week we have two friends joining us from West Valley Water District. We have Socorro, Pantaleon, and Mary Jo Hartley. Thank you so much for being here, you guys. We are so excited to have you on our Talk of the Town podcast.
Well, we are very happy to be here today to share all West Valley.
Woohoo! Let's talk some water. Exciting stuff. I know. Those of you that are listening, you don't know that you're going to be so excited, but wait till we dig into all this info because you guys are doing such a great job. But before we get into all the nitty gritty of all things West Valley Water, start off by telling us a little bit about yourselves. What are your official titles and what exactly do you do at West Valley Water District?
So my name is Socorro Pantaleon. I'm the manager of public outreach and government affairs here at the Water District, at West Valley Water District. And what we handle is the outreach, the communication aspect of sharing what we do and how we do it here at the district and how we provide our customers with safe and safe, reliable, high quality water. We also handle the legislative part of the district. So we work with our state and federal lobbyists, our local electeds, to advocate on behalf of our customers to ensure that their voices are being heard up in Sacramento and DC.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mary Jo. I am the senior public outreach and government affairs rep, and I do everything that she does under her guidance.
I love it. Well, you are being led very well. Socorro, I've known you for quite a while, and seeing you transition into this role has just been really amazing. You've done a phenomenal job, and we'll get into some of the things that you've been leading and under your events and just all the things. It's a lot, and people don't realize when they get their water bill every month or they turn on the faucet, all that goes behind everything that you guys do with water, right? I think we take it for granted. It's like, oh, the water is always there, but there's a lot that goes into it. So that's really what we want to dig into today. Now you're talking, I heard a lot of like legislative, government affairs, like let's dig into that a little bit in terms of this particular region, especially, but just your roles. What does that look like on a day-to-day basis?
Oh gosh, day-to-day.
I think we could take this one if you don't mind.
Yeah.
The great thing about being part of West Valley Water District is we do a lot for our communities and the fact that we provide this valuable resource, but our days never look the same. Some days we're putting out information about water resources and rebates. Some days we're talking with our local elected officials to try to advocate on behalf of our customers. Some days we're just trying to write a really catchy social media post. So we're very lucky in the fact that we don't do the same thing every day, but we're continuously working toward the same commitment to our communities.
You're making water fun, I feel like.
We try.
Water's not just for drinking anymore. There's so much behind it, right?
And this month we're celebrating Water Quality Month. So we're highlighting our water quality team who tests our water to ensure that the water that we provide our customers is reliable and to drink.
Yeah. Hey, we appreciate that. And if you're excited about something, right, I feel like everybody else will get excited about it. And I think that's something that you've done a really great job. You've made it come to life. And I know you guys have your mascot. Can we talk about your mascots real quick?
You want to do the book?
Yeah, sure. I don't know if you guys can see this.
You're not watching. You're totally missing out on this. Go on YouTube to see them. All right, tell me about these guys. They're adorable.
So this one is Creek. And this is, Creek the Conservationist and Hallie H2O. And they're our newest water stewards that help us engage with our youngest water stewards at a more fun and exciting level and kind of gets the kids excited to join in on being a water saver.
I'm not young.
Like stickers, right?
They are stickers, yes.
I was going to say, we need some at the chamber office because I want to get a couple of those for
sure. I know. Well, we were talking about getting stuffed animals because they're darn cute. And if you're listening and you're not watching, Hallie has pink cowgirl boots on and a pink bow. And I got to actually meet her in person and got a photo with her at your Earth Day event. So cute, so fun. And I love that, like I said, you know, you're making water more appealing, right, to the kiddos. And we'll talk a little bit more about your conservation efforts and getting them involved. But good job, you guys. You're making it fun. I love it.
So go ahead.
No, they're very popular in the community. The kids love, like, when the mascot comes out and when we have goodies on the table, they're just like, they want those stickers and they want to learn more about water.
That's awesome. Well, talking about outreach, especially if you're talking about kids, talk to us a little bit more about West Valley Water District. A lot of folks, they know you guys are a water agency, but they don't really know what you guys do. What do you service? Part of your board. So enlighten folks a little bit about exactly the overall of West Valley.
So we serve over 100,000 customers, 25,000 connections. So that's residential and commercial connections. We do serve 5 cities and 2 counties. So we serve the city of Fontana, Rialto, Colton, Bloomington, Heruba Valley, and San Bernardino, Riverside County. And our community is very unique because we have some areas that are considered very disadvantaged, but we also have another part of our community that is growing. We have new development coming in. So, you know, we look at both sides and how we can ensure that we have water for our customers that we already have, and then adding more supply to it for the future customers.
Yeah, and then we are very fortunate in the fact that most of our water comes from local sources. About 96% comes from local sources here in San Bernardino County, including 5 of our basins, with just 4% of that water being imported.
Wow, did everybody catch that that's listening? Our water is local water. And I know here in the city of Fontana, it's in our logo, right? We've got the fountain, but isn't there a considerable amount of water, even just here, groundwater with the water table?
Definitely, yeah.
We're very lucky here in this area.
And you would never think that, right? Looking around that we have all this water underground. So you're not getting, we're not getting imported water from somewhere else. I mean, it's all local. Coming here from the region. That's really interesting. Now, you guys are located on Baseline, right? Baseline and Cactus in Rialto, your home office. So that's where you're sitting at today. And then I wanted to talk quickly about your board. How many members are on your board? Talk about what's their role? What do they do?
So we currently have, we have a 5-member board. We have director, President Young, Greg Young, Vice President Daniel Jenkins, Director Angela Garcia, Director Talvin Moore, and then we just had Director Channing Hawkins step down. So we have a vacancy right now. So we have 4 board members, and they are our advocates in the community. They our board is kind of like a council where we have meetings twice a month, the first third Thursday of the month at 6 p.m. You can view the meetings online. And they make decisions on behalf of the district regarding projects, capital improvement projects, other funding sources.
They live in our district. They are water is West Valley Water. So they really truly act as a voice to our customers. So it's great to have them.
You know what I like is that you stream this, also your meetings live?
Yes.
You know, and that's huge because I think you're the first water company that I've actually heard that does that. So kudos to you guys, setting the standard high for sure, you know?
Yeah. We want to make sure people...
Transparency, right? Like that you've really been implementing, yeah. And I think people appreciate that, right? Because like I said, most of the time people don't really think about it. I think we probably deal with it more because we're in California and it's always in our face. It seems like we're always in a drought or everyone's always talking about water conservation and all of those things. And so I think... taking that proactive approach, like you said, you know, getting out in the community, making yourselves known, getting, you know, people involved with your meetings. Water's it's exciting stuff, right? I mean, I'm sure these meetings are very informative, but like you said, new projects coming in and just things that directly impact our region, that's important for anybody who's consuming any type of service or good from an agency. And so I'm looking behind you at this new building up in your office. Can we talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, so that's the RP Rover filtration facility. That's where our water, our surface water gets treated from Lago Creek. We're currently right now, we're expanding from 14.4 to 21.7 MGDs.
Million gallons per day. So we're able to treat so much water now, the 14.4 million gallons per day at this facility. But with the expansion upgrade, we'll be able to add an additional 0.2 million gallons per day that we can treat in order to help our growing communities, say like in Fontana and Northern Rio. So
everything's growing. I feel like I drive up Sierra and like the vacant land is dwindling, which is great. We have a mayor and council who are so pro development, and that obviously, you know, you service part of Fontana, but you got to have water, right? To meet the demands. So let's talk about some water issues for a moment. Is there anything that's coming to mind, whether it's privately or, you know, private residents or impacting our business community? Are there any issues or anything that's going on right now that people can be aware of?
Yeah, sure. So the state recently adopted new regulations. They're called Making Conservation a California Way of Life. And they're based on two prior 2018 regulations. And basically what it does is gives each water district a unique water efficiency objective that they have to meet. Here in the Inland Empire, we have been hit the hardest on these regulations because we do have so much groundwater available to us. With that being said, our specific objective we need to meet is 30% reduction by 2040, which does sound like a lot, but our customers have really done the work in the past few years to save water. And together, I know we can save even more.
Yeah, and we'll be working with our residential and commercial customers to continue showcasing the rebates we have in programs. We offer plentiful conservation programs online and through the district that I know our customers will tap into this and will help us continue the messaging of conservation.
And I thought at some point I saw a box somewhere floating around your office.
So we have this unique little box called the Conservation Starts at Home. We're actually going to revamp it this year with our mascots, but we've had this for about 2 years now. And inside this little kid, we have conservation goodies, hose nozzles, toilet tabs, shower heads, sink, aerators. So we take those out to the community. Well, some people have them at booths, or if a customer is interested, they can come to our customer service department, fill out a form, and they get a nice little kit to take home.
And it's free.
It's free.
Wow, you guys, there's nothing better than free.
We really want to encourage water saving.
I love it.
So you're talking about outreach, and you're also talking about these kits and events maybe. Talk a little bit about what events do you put on throughout the year, and how can folks get involved?
So one of our fan favorite events in the community is our poster contest. It is open to first sixth graders in our service area. And each year we have a theme and they draw to the theme. This year's theme is water
saving means.
The new theme, so I'm still trying to remember it.
This was our last year's calendar, which was made from the winning posters.
That's cool. That's very cool.
So cute. We love those calendars. And you can stop by your office and get one of those, right? So it has all the drawings and everything that the kiddos made and their name and what school they go to. And
yeah, so the contest is open right now. We'll have submissions mid-October, and then we'll have a voting contest on that. We'll be voting on that, and then we recognize the students in December. So by December, we'll have these beautiful calendars out.
I love it. Now, who does the voting? Is it the board or the staff?
The staff. Mm-hmm. Okay. Board. Yeah.
A tough job.
A fan favorite, having them vote.
that's a hard job, especially with all those drawings. It's like, who's actually going to make it, you know?
Yeah.
And then we just, last year we kicked off our essay contest or scholarship contest. Mm-hmm. It was on water conservation regulations. And we did a part of the contest, which was a essay contest, and the part was a video contest. And we actually had two winners this year, and they were recognized at our meeting earlier in June. And so there were two of our first winners. So, and we're going to bring the program back this year. We're just kind of finishing the last touches on it. So stay tuned on our website and on social media. We'll be announcing when it goes live.
Now, is this contest open to anybody or?
High school students in our service area.
Okay, so if you're a high school student in West Valley, serviced by West Valley Water District, then they enter the contest and then they get a scholarship potentially.
Yeah, senior high school students are going to a 4-year or 2-year
or a trade school.
Yeah.
Within the next school year.
Yeah. Are you allowed to share the amount?
Yeah, $1,000.
Wow. Hey, that's awesome.
A little scholarship.
Yeah. All right, kids, get ready.
All right, so we've got the poster contest. We've got the scholarship video contest. What else do you guys have going on throughout the year?
You want to talk about? Sure. So we are part of several regional education efforts, including the Water Education Water
Awareness Committee. Awareness Committee.
So many letters. And basically what they do is they also provide a larger area for scholarships, both for students and for teachers. And so throughout the year, they highlight those programs. And it's a group of us local water agencies that get together in order to provide that. So it's just able to reach a larger number of students and teachers. Additionally, we last year just chaired the Inland Solar Challenge, which has just changing its name from Inland Solar Challenge to the SoCal STEAM Challenge. And basically what it is a program where high school students throughout the year build and then race at the end of the year 16-foot solar powered boats. And during that time when they're building them, they learn about water, the water industry, careers in water, careers in just science, technology, engineering, and math. And then they come together with local students all across the Inland Empire to race those boats and see who wins.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So where did they race these boats at?
Ukaipa Regional Park.
Oh my goodness. That's cool. And then I want to talk about Earth Day because I had such a good time at Earth Day. That was back in April, right? All right. Tell everybody who, if they've never been, tell them about Earth Day.
Well, our West Valley's Earth Day and Open House is our time where we open the doors to the community, showcase our departments, what we do, so you can come and learn what we do here. You can also take a tour of our treatment plant on site. We also have local vendors here. We have entertainment, local kids and our dance classes will come and do a little performance. We have a face painter. We have a reptile show. We try to mix it up every year a little differently. So next year will be a surprise. So we'll see what we come up with, trying to change it up a little bit. What other things we do?
I think it's really just a way to get our staff, our local electeds, and our communities together to just kind of collaborate and kind of see eye to eye on different subject matters, whether that's careers in water, what we do, how we do it, things of that nature, and really just have a day of community.
I love it. And you guys do a phenomenal job. And you have to mention the food. Last time you guys had the habit there and it's all free. And I think that's just really cool because sometimes if you've never been to your guys' campus, you can easily just drive by and say, oh, that's the water place, you know, but really opening your doors allows the community to come in and it brings it to life. And I think you're really hitting each age group, right? You've got the kids involved. You've got your high schoolers, you've got adults, you're really providing that education on all fronts and being proactive. So kudos to you guys for thinking outside of the box, but just making water cool. You know what I mean? I think that people hear about these things and they think, oh, it's just water, but it's not. And it's such a vital part of our everyday lives. So I think bringing the awareness, but also the engagement, because who knows, maybe there's that fourth grader, you know, sitting in that classroom and gets connected with you guys and maybe goes to Earth Day and sees the mascots and just, it changes their life, right? Maybe they see a new career path that they never even knew was available to them. And they think, oh my gosh, I was meant to do X, Y, or Z, you know? So it's great. You guys do a great job providing all of those meaningful opportunities and really just that community engagement. I got to go this year. Thank you for inviting the chamber. We had a blast. And you guys just really put on a phenomenal event. Can't wait for the next one. I know that'll be a lot of fun.
April 19th, 2025.
Okay. All right. 2025, guys. We got the date. Put it on your calendars now. You don't want to miss it. Really, really a great event. But I just wanted to say personally from the Fontana Chamber of Commerce, a huge thank you to you and your team and just West Valley Water District as a whole for being such great supporters of the Fontana Chamber and our business community. You guys have partnered with us on our State of the City, our gala, and just so many other things in between. So we so appreciate your engagement with the Fontana business community and just all of your generosity towards all that we're accomplishing here.
Yeah, we're very grateful to be your partners with the Chamber in Fontana. And just continue being that resource to you and the community, sharing how we provide water and that reliable, high quality water.
I love it. Well, thanks, guys. We appreciate you. That's going to wrap up this week's episode of Talk of the Town. Remember, if you're tuning in, we drop a new episode every Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. You don't want to miss it. Thank you so much again to West Valley Water District. Mary Jo, Socorro, you guys are awesome. Keep up the amazing work in our community. We appreciate you guys. And for all of our listeners, don't forget, we are on all major streaming platforms. So if you're watching us on YouTube, don't forget, you can put us on in the car while you're running on the treadmill at the gym or running an errand in your car. We're on all major streaming platforms. You can listen, you can watch, but we appreciate you turning the dial to tune in.
That's right.
We appreciate you guys. And once again, thank you, Carlos. Thank you, ladies. And we'll catch you guys next time on the Talk of the Town podcast.